Uh-oh. I tapped out of chivalry.
Why would the archer not be the fastest class? I'd just like to know that. That's kind of stupid.
Don't question the game.
I wanna know how the heck they got so much points for this.
Ooh.
Sacrifice him to summon the horde? Why did you just stab me?
Oh. Don't sacrifice him yet.
Why?
Please no.
Well, we can't buy anything anyway, right?
Oh. I guess not.
Oh, wait, hang on, some stuff is free.
Is it?
Yes. The stuff up at the beginning. God dang it. Only like the stuff in the front is free.
I could not resist.
Pause. I'm just trying to do stuff over here.
Could not resist.
Okay, I'm getting the short bow. Is that guy on my team? He does not look like it.
Oh, no.
Oh, you are. You don't have an indicator on top of you. What the heck?
No, my indicator and yours is like glitched out.
Really? Okay.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah! The kick is effective.
I think I stabbed you in the foot.
Don't do that. Why are you after me all the time?
I wasn't. I was... Oh, look, there's a big man.
I gotta go away from him.
Okay, I'm gonna lure the big man over to the spikes.
Yeah, you lure him. You do that. Oh, yeah, let's find out what the spikes do while we're in an early wave.
Ooh. It didn't work out. Come kick him.
Dude. How do you kick him into the spikes? Okay.
F.
Oh, yeah! Get wrecked!
Woo!
That was amazing! So proud of you.
Ow.
Get wrecked. Purchase items at the inn.
That was magic.
Can we go in the inn?
That was magical.
Why would you buy a shield, you dummy? I'm going the bow route. Wait, is this guy dead?
Oh.
So how did you just kick him or did you like bash him? I bet if you have a shield you could...
I kicked him.
Oh, I thought it was you hitting me and I was like not panicked and then I turned around and then it was a guy and I was panicked. Okay, I'm getting wrecked.
I accidentally bought a sling.
They're effective though. You move fast. Okay, don't hit me because I'm about to die, darn it. I'm gonna get food.
Ooh, I got the guy that was behind you, I think.
Nice.
I did. And you weren't even, caught in the crossfire?
No, I wasn't. I was pretty good. The slings are solid. I might grab one. Okay, I did not
grab a sling. Defend the peasants! Oh, no. Exploit has joined the game. No. Jeez.
Why is that bad?
Oh, that's my friend Matt.
Oh, exploit. Yeah, exploit.
He's a bit of a dingus. A dingus.
Okay. I forgot that the sling gets rid of your sword. Crap.
Yeah.
That's okay. I'm better with ranged weapons than this. I can't afford a bow yet.
Ooh. The masons are coming from... I'm on fire. I'm on fire.
Don't let those mongrels
reach the villagers.
I like that they say the same thing to both of us.
And it's just endless.
Yes.
Half the time.
It's great. I love it. Oh, get wrecked! Oh, that's you. I do not like that your indicator doesn't come above your name because I keep wanting to hit you. True aggro drawing. What is he doing? Nobody open this door.
How much is the door? I might just go open it myself.
I kill you.
Don't buy doors. Pulse. Oh, it's 200. Wow. Yeah, I'm getting good. Thanks, Matt.
He's killing you, so you... Yeah. Way to go, Matt. Kill him so he won't open a door.
Get out of here. Jesus. You're such a bad friend. You're a horrible person, Matt.
You... Oh my gosh, there's a guy there.
I have video evidence. Get out of here. Jesus! Oh!
The sling is effective, alright, that's all I'm saying. Uh-oh. Oh, right in through.
Such a bad person he is.
I'm horrible. Saving him. He's about to die.
No, kill him. Let him die. Let him die. Oh, ooh, beside you. Beside you.
Are you dead right now?
Yes, I was murdered. By a teammate. Exploit. In cold blood. So cold.
Oh my gosh, I'm being shot by so many things right now.
Oh, I have to buy my sling again. Great. GG. Matthew. GG.
Oh! What? How did I just hit that guy's head off with a sling? What the heck?
That was a nice kill.
Oh, another one! Did I hit him in the skull with that?
Who needs Doge Cam when you have Devon Cam?
Yeah, that's true.
Exactly. Of course, nobody can see what I see.
Did you say... Never mind.
Do you see what I see?
Do you see... That's not the same song. That's not the words. Why did I get the bow? I was doing so good with the sling. What am I thinking? I'm going back to the sling. The sling has unlimited ammo.
Ow! Oh, that did a lot of damage.
I love this game.
Ow. That was brutal. Well, and yeah, and you can just hold...
My bow's like floating out in front of my body. I'm so glitchy right now.
Ooh. Ooh.
Uh-oh. He's left.
Ooh, you're in my way.
Oh my gosh, this guy's so... Oh, is he the leader?
No.
Horde linebacker. I thought he was a linebacker. It's
an American.
A horde defender.
Just sees like the word line and just thinks football.
Yeah, exactly.
Just immediate first thought is it's a linebacker.
Yep, pretty much.
Do you sell propane and propane accessories perhaps as well?
What?
No. You don't sell propane and propane accessories?
Yeah, I do.
And live in Texas?
Yeah, I do.
Do all of your exes?
Don't you know everybody in America lives in Texas? Yes, all my exes also live in Texas.
There we go. I just quoted every bit of American culture I know.
Is that like what Canadians think of America? They all live in Texas?
No. Oh. We Canadians are very well informed about what goes on in the U.S.
Are you?
In fact, half of our news is about the U.S.
No way, is it really?
Nothing goes on in our own country.
Because you're all too polite. We're so cool. Exactly. Oh, I just took off your helmet!
What? You took off my helmet?
That's not funny, but it was really funny.
Come here.
Oh,
Come here.
I'm staying away from you. No, go away.
Get over here, you.
Okay, I'm getting the hammer. Even though it goes against... God dang it, stop!
He's killing me again.
Oh, this is a bad hammer. Why did I get it? It's so small. References of it.
I need help. He's evading everything I'm throwing at him.
Who is the enemy or exploit?
No, exploit.
Oh, he's attacking me now!
Just keep running.
Oh, there's people coming in. Okay, now I have to attack real enemies because they're about to kill me. Hey, there's a horde linebacker again. He's a warrior, actually.
Linebacker.
So do you eat lots of poutine?
No.
No? Why not?
No. I don't know. You get kind of tired of it after a while.
Do you? What? Okay, what?
You know what they... Oh, he chopped my head off.
What kind of cheese do they put on poutine? Is it just like a fake cheese?
No, normally it's Quebec cheese curds.
Quebec cheese curds.
Quebec cheese curds, that's where the original were from.
And what kind of gravy do you put on it?
Usually, I think they just use like a brown gravy type of thing.
Just a brown gravy? Yeah. Okay.
Just of some description. I don't know. You know what they do?
My girlfriend's saying all these things right before you say them to you.
Do you have like poutine at McDonald's in America?
No. Oh, you have poutine at McDonald's?
We do.
No way.
It's McDonald's fries.
My girlfriend just said, let's go to Canada.
Cheese curds with gravy on top. It's great.
It's McDonald's fries with cheese curds and gravy on top?
Yeah.
So wait, is it like French fries or is that the kind of fries?
French fries. Yeah, yes.
Okay. I wasn't sure if it was like tater tots or something like that.
No. No.
Because there's a restaurant that just opened by me. And it's like, it's just like a diner. I don't know if you guys have like they serve pancakes and waffles and burgers and stuff like that. And
yes, we do have all day breakfast places.
Yes, that's what. Well, they're not really all day, but like
basically all day.
Some days they're open till like 1:30. So yeah, basically all day. All of the like rational day. But okay, so they have all bunch of American classics and stuff. But then they have just randomly on the menu they have poutine. And they have it, there's like 50 things on the menu, right? And then there's poutine, and under poutine is the French translation of it. And it's literally the only thing on the menu translated into French.
Weird.
So we've been thinking about poutine a lot. I think, I'm thinking about ordering it, just so I can tell you what it tastes like.
Great.
Now. Well, it might not be great here, because put crappy Velveeta cheese on it here.
Oh, did you know that Velveeta is like one chemical reaction away from being plastic?
Yeah, but I mean,
how horrifying is that?
I don't know.
Dirty do you feel as an American for
it's just oil.
That? It's not just oil.
Yeah, that's all it is. That's
if
all
it was
plastic
just oil,
is.
It would be a little better.
But I love Velveeta, good. Darn it! All right, I'm a true American.
In
I gotta go.
In home ec, they taught us how bad it was.
Oh, yeah.
And they made us cook and eat with it.
They taught you how bad it was and made you use it?
Yes, like and then made us use it in a recipe, and it was disgusting.
Like, to prove their point, or to be,
it's
like,
olive oil.
Hypocrites?
Oh, it was disgusting. Yeah, and we do have schools here.
You do?
Yes.
Wow, I never knew that.
And we don't live in igloos.
You seem so uneducated, though. Just kidding.
Yeah, we don't live in igloos either.
Well, I wouldn't think... No, I did think
so. You would be surprised... Okay, I went to Disney World like a million years ago. And you would be surprised how many people... Like when you told them, oh yeah, we're from Saskatchewan. And they're like, oh, where's Saskatchewan? In Canada. And they'd be like, oh, is that... Oh, what did the one guy say? Is that near Texas or something?
What?
And it's like, what? It was like, no.
We don't have Texas.
It was like, no. It was like
for cooking class, our final was to get diabetes. Is Exploit from Canada?
Yes, he is.
Is he from your school, like real life friend?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes. Cool. We used to be neighbors.
Hi, Sayo. Sorry, I didn't say hi. We were in the middle of things.
Ow!
I strafe like a pro.
Oh, there's bad men coming.
Should probably worry about them for a little bit. And then we both go back to shooting each other. You dead?
No.
Oh god.
Way to go.
Oh god.
GG.
Oh my gosh, that guy does half my health.
Good. I hope you die a painful death.
I mean, I probably will, to be honest. I hope you feel
bad. And then have to go to a hospital and pay, like, your whole retirement fund. For, like, just to see a doctor.
Wait, why would I do that?
Because you're an American and you don't have free healthcare.
Well, we have health insurance.
Well, yeah. In Canada, it's all free. It's all free, man. It's all free. It's not great, but it's free.
But my insurance is great. I can get whatever I want.
like what's the weight? I don't remember. Like, for, like, the past, like, 4 or 5 years, they've been trying to get the the ER wait time down to like an hour.
Oh my gosh, right now, down to an hour?
Right now it's probably around like during the holidays and stuff, and on weekends you get like the drunk First Nations in there, and basically like we have really bad people in First Nations communities. Most of them do bad things with their lives.
Yeah, I that's an American
thing. And and okay. Basically, so yeah, so there will be just like these, like a ton of like drunk people at the hospital because they've all like gotten stabbed. Yes, yes, Matthew, they do build wigwams.
Wait, you've been and, what? What's that? Is that an igloo?
No. Basically, like a wigwam is like a First Nations like teepee. You might know it as a teepee.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Native American thing.
Yes. Yeah. See, you can't call them Native Americans because one, they're not Americans.
No. So like a teepee is Native American. First
Nations.
Thing.
Yeah. No, but wait. In Canada they're called First Nations.
Because they're the first.
You gotta get it right. They get really insulted if you say Indian.
Well, yeah, that makes sense because they're not Indians, but they are Native Americans. Even in Canada, they're Native Americans. Because Canada is part of North America.
They don't like that.
But they are! See, like I'm the kind of person that I don't care. Like, I'm going to call you what you are, basically. So, like...
So, one time, I was in the hospital, and I was, like, you could be there, like, all night, and you won't even see a doctor.
Oh, gosh, that hammer sucks. Really?
Like, you won't... Oh, yeah, you could be there, like... For hours, like, and hours. Like, you could get there at, like, midnight and still be there at, like, noon. And you might have seen a doctor.
That's terrible.
And, hey, do you want to hear the stupidest thing? Okay, so they're building a children's hospital, which is good.
Yeah, that's good.
Only thing is, okay, our current hospital, like, the Saskatoon Health Region, that's, like, my city's health region. There's not enough beds for all the people they have admitted. So they have to send patients to other hospitals outside the health region.
And
meanwhile, they built a new hospital in like 2000-ish.
Yeah.
It's called City Hospital. It's like right downtown and it's empty. It's basically empty.
That's like, stupid.
but they have to build this brand new children's hospital, and they're building it right next to the Royal University Hospital, and it's already like over budget, and they haven't even built it yet. Like, they're nowhere near starting to build it.
Just like prepping is over budget.
And it's just like, it's so stupid. One whole side of the building is going to be looking at another building. And so, there's going to be, like, a foot in between the buildings.
So let me get this right. After telling me that my nation's stupid for not having universal health care, you went on to tell me all the reasons that universal health care is terrible.
Hey, you have Obamacare.
Yeah, but Obamacare is selective.
So quality.
But Obamacare won't be around for very long. It'll leave. Oh, God. Oh, my gosh, I'm dying.
Gonna get you payback time.
Oh my gosh! Run faster! That's a bad get, I think.
I'm walking like side by side with a not nice man.
Why are you killing me?
Retribution time.
You're just mad that I'm doing so good, darn it.
Retribution time. Retribution time.
How come I can't get health?
Come back here.
Dang it!
you died.
Look at comments. I'm looking at the comments. What am I playing? I'm playing...
I'm gonna die. Oh, I died.
Chivalry. It's a game where you kill people. See, that's what you get. You died because you killed me. God dang it. So, okay. Alright, so... I'm in pharmacy school, right, which is medical school, so I know a bit about healthcare in other countries. Mm. And From my experience, universal healthcare doesn't work out very well.
It works if it's properly funded.
But it's
the last... Okay, we just had like an election last year.
Yeah.
Which you probably heard of, because everybody loves our new prime minister.
No, I did not hear about that. We don't, you we know don't what? Really hear about other people's elections.
Anymore. Everybody loves Trudeau now, okay?
Trudeau?
Everybody was like gaga for him for like a week, okay? You got just look him up later, Justin Trudeau.
I don't know who that is.
He's a neat guy. Okay, so basically, the old Conservative Party, they've been in since like 2008, I think.
Uh-huh.
And the Prime Minister, Stephen Harper, he was getting a little, you know, kind of slow. So he got replaced. And basically, we haven't had like any healthcare funding increases since like 2010. Which means even as the population has grown, the budget hasn't for the healthcare.
So, X-Men says the dollars. I'm sorry, keep going.
What did he say?
I don't know. It's the same thing he said in chat. It was hilarious. About the dollar. You were talking about that earlier, too.
66 cents.
All right, anyways, keep
telling. It's not the liberals' fault. Okay, yeah. So, basically, okay. The other funny thing is 90% of our economy was based on, like, oil.
Sure. Right, and then fracking so happened, right? And that ruined everything.
No. It's just when oil... Because oil's now worth, you know, like $20
nothing?
A barrel.
Right.
So all of this money is just all of a sudden gone.
It went from like 60 to 20 in like a year, so.
It was closer to 100, I think.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're right. It was. It was like 100, was not even 60. I'm thinking like years back it was 60. It was like 100 last year, and now it's 20.
So the province to the west of Saskatchewan is Alberta, and that's where a lot of the oil is produced and stuff. Because way up north, they have oil sands, so the oil is trapped in all this, like, sand and stuff.
Yeah, I've heard of that.
Yeah, and basically...
Well, you got Canada, your main export is oil.
Yes.
Well, we start over? We start over because of you.
Alberta is drunker than my sex life.
Okay, he's so... The same age, okay, so you're...
Okay, yeah, anyway, continue.
I can't, because I'm dying here. Get off me, ho!
What's in Alberta?
God, I just died to... Oh, was that explained? God dang it, guys! what were we talking about?
Oil.
Yeah, because you guys were... that's where your economy was from, was exporting oil, as far as I know.
Basically, mainly. We have oil, agriculture, and, mining. Like, Saskatchewan has, like, a lot of potash, and they use potash in agricultural to make fertilizer.
Yeah, we got basically nothing in America.
Yeah, basically not. You just kind of mooch off of all the other countries.
We don't export anymore.
No. No, 100% import, mostly from China.
Yeah, and, okay, but here's the deal. The reason gas went down is because we started fracking, which means we've actually started tapping into our oil supply in our country all over the place, and that's why oil prices went down so much.
There was that, and with all this stuff going on in the Middle East.
Yeah, that too.
That. Really puts a hindrance on the price.
Yeah, and everybody's like, this is so great for the economy, but it's not actually.
It's not. It's so bad.
Going down's good, but going down that fast is really bad.
Yes. And it's like, we're, like, before the election, the government, you know, their financial people, whatever, the revenue branch or whatever, said that we were technically in a recession.
Yeah.
Because there had been like 5 straight months with loss. Like the economy hadn't grown any. And it still hasn't really started to grow again. Like the agriculture and stuff was good. But all the oil just went down. Do you have a bully?
Yes! God dang it!
Beat him up, beat him up, beat him up.
Alright, I'm gonna kick your friend, isn't it? Right, we're gonna leave.
I wonder if there's a way we can vote kick him.
Yeah.
Player list. Exploit. Vote kick.
If I knew your friend in real life, he would be hurt tomorrow.
Press insert to vote yes.
Wait, what?
Press insert to vote yes.
Insert. Get out of here. How did you start a vote? How did you do that?
You press escape, and then you go to player list.
Oh. So we just lost again. See, the key is, I have to be alive. Because I put the team on my back.
Well, there was only the four of us.
The what of us?
Oh, jeez. Oh, goodness.
Okay, so... Wait, so when you guys say liberal... What do you guys mean by liberal?
Liberal.
How do you guys define? Because, okay, in America we have liberals and conservatives, right? Yeah. Canada does too.
Yeah.
Right? But
yeah.
50 years ago in America, liberal and conservatives were the opposite of what they are now.
Yeah.
So that's why. Yeah, I asked.
That would be like your classical liberal and conservative. Because nowadays they're almost kind of mirrored, like yeah. They've almost kind of flipped.
Yeah. Yeah. Is that how it is in Canada?
No. The liberals would like to have, you know, everybody kind of even Stevens.
Sure. And conservatives Whereas say the, you the get cons- what you earn.
The conservatives were kind of... I don't know. Everybody was kind of the same, really. But we have another party, too. Like, another big party called the NDP.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. So, in the beginnings, they were actually, like, basically a communist party.
That's bad. Maybe.
But now they're just kind of not? I don't know. They're the new democratic party. So, take that with a grain of salt, if you will.
Yeah, you keep his dirty mongos up. Well... I just want to say, in most countries, universal healthcare doesn't work out.
No. Well, which country is it that has the really good universal healthcare? Is it like Sweden or something?
I thought in America we think Canada has the most successful universal healthcare.
Well, it works, but it doesn't work all at the same time.
That's what I'm saying. Because, like, I have Obamacare now, but like so now my health insurance sucks. Okay, but before I had... Healthcare Alliance, and they were good, and basically it's like you go where you want, and mm-hmm. I mean you have to have like a doctor's referral for stuff, yeah. But why wouldn't you?
Well, we do too.
Yeah,
like you can't just go in to like just any specialist and be like, oh, take me.
But like here in America, the expected ER wait time can't be over an hour. Like where I'm from, I don't think like the. I'm from a fairly small area, but the average ER wait time was 5 minutes, so...
Yeah. Well, and that's the difference, though. You know, like, those doctors have more incentive, whereas ours are just trying to keep above water.
Exactly.
Because there's not as many of them.
Well, that's what I think. The problem with free healthcare is that it means it's free, so, I mean, the quality goes down. Overall.
Well, in theory... Like, if the government put more money into the healthcare, there would be better healthcare.
Yeah, but...
But with oil the way it is, there's not really a lot of extra money.
To put more money into it, you'd have to pretty much tax people more.
Yeah, the liberal plan is to run a deficit to try and kickstart the economy.
That never works out.
But it might, because that's what they did in 2008. Yeah. They just, like, you know... They didn't.
Oh, that's a teammate. Sorry.
Like, what did we do? Like, all these infrastructure projects.
Yeah.
Were brought forward. Like, Saskatoon got the rest of our freeway built with the money from that. Because this is a funny story. Our freeway is called Circle Drive, and like just 3 years ago, it finally was a circle around the whole city. Yeah.
The free. Yeah. That's pretty funny.
Before it was just like a sea.
That's funny. Well, in America, we privatized pretty much everything.
Yeah, exactly.
Lately, like, within the last like 10 years, we've moved away from that, but stuff has gotten worse since we've done that.
Like the big cell phone and internet provider in Saskatchewan is SaskTel, and it's owned by the government.
What? The cell phone provider is owned by the government?
Yes. Like, we have Bell and Telus and stuff, but the SaskTel stuff is, it like all the profits go back into the province.
That's one thing I would almost prefer here is if the cell phone companies were controlled by the government, to be honest.
Yeah. Like, the prices aren't, like, it's not like the prices are cheaper than, you know, Bell or something.
Yeah. I mean, the telephone service in America used to be by the government, but...
Yeah, everything used to be by the government.
Yeah, pretty much, I guess. So, I don't know, because in America, with all the cell phone providers, it just gets to be such a, like, a wreck with all of that. Because everybody's just charging what they want, and
their exactly.
And, the gimmicks they have are stupid, and...
Well, yeah.
They pull silly crap, and... Yeah, that's one bad thing about our system.
Yeah. Like we do have all the private ones, too, but everything's fairly regulated. Like, the one major airline used to be owned by the government. They're privatized now. Yeah. But they used to be.
Yeah, we're all privatizing the airline.
Yeah. Yeah, they all are now, but the one used to be, it was Air Canada. Hardy har. Air Canada sucks. Don't ever fly Air Canada.
Please. American Airlines sucks too.
Don't give Air Canada your money.
Well, you're the first. Okay, so when we discuss healthcare at my school and in America, everybody always says universal healthcare can work because Canadians are always happy with their healthcare.
We used to be.
I've never talked to an actual Canadian about this. So
we used to be. That's the thing, is it used to be real good, right. But without, like, we just haven't innovated and invested, which means we have aging infrastructure, we have just, like, it's just all, like, it would be good if it had been maintained.
Yeah, but without universal healthcare, you don't run into that problem, so.
No.
I guess you could, but you're less likely to, it seems like. Because everybody needs healthcare.
Well, exactly. Yeah. Like, that's, like, people really don't want privatization, though. Like, it's been brought up a couple of times. Like, just recently we started allowing private liquor stores.
Really?
Yes.
Wait, you have government-owned liquor stores?
Yes.
Wow!
Yeah, liquor boards.
Wow, you're, like, in the third world.
Well, and they provide, like, everything else, like, everything that you could get at a, like, like a private one. It's just the money from that goes into, like, your fire and your roads and your police.
Actually, that kind of makes sense.
Yeah. Well, so here, they allowed, we have a Sobeys liquor store now.
Uh-huh.
And we have a Co-op liquor store. The Co-op is basically, like, it's a, like, you can buy into it.
Uh-huh.
So, like, you can pay, like, I don't remember how much the premium is, like, your first year, and you get a check at the end of the year if you buy stuff there.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, we buy fuel there, and at the end of the year, you get a check for part of your fuel, like, for part of however much you paid.
Oh, really?
I opened the door.
Why? Well, okay, in America, like, we have an alcohol tax. And that's kind of our version, which is kind of the same. It's basically same in the end.
We have an alcohol tax too, I think.
Oh, you have an alcohol tax and the government sells the alcohol. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we have, like, because we have, like, our PST and GST.
Did Canada go through a time when they had prohibition?
Yes, because Al Capone was here. doing things in Saskatchewan.
And so they did Produce and History Farm. We did that too. It didn't go very well here.
Yes, that's why Al Capone was here. We had Al Capone. In fact, they're called the Tunnels of Moose Jaw. They're really cool. I would look it up. You can actually go there, and it's kind of like a theatrical experience now, and you can see all these like tunnels from Prohibition.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It's, yeah, and according to all these people, you know, like, oh yeah, Al Capone was in Moose Jaw, eh? And had some sort of underground tunnel system to move his liquor around. It's very interesting.
Well, we took down Al Capone, so...
Yeah, and then you had that guy try and look in his vaults.
Oh, I don't know about that. But we took him down for tax fraud in America.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's lame. But that's the only way they could get him.
It's so funny watching that video of the guy. He's like, ooh, we'll find out what's in Al Capone's vault. Opens it up, nothing.
Oh, I've never then heard of that.
He just does a little dance and walks away.
What is that? Don't kick me. I know. I knew you were going to do that too.
Come back here.
Can you actually kick me into him?
I don't know. I don't
think
so.
Let's find out.
Let's find out.
Well, do I get to come back alive now? Yay, I get to come back. No, I don't.
Come look at your body, quick.
Wait.
Where are you?
I'm floating around. That is amazing.
I cut off your arm. I'm going to cut off your head.
What the deuce?
I got this, guys.
Darn it, I have to wait the whole wave now. Gosh darn it.
Oh, great. GG.
Well, Canadian politics is interesting. I didn't know all this stuff about Canadian politics. So next time somebody tells me it works because Canadians like it, I'll say, well, I know differently.
Yeah, you have a Canadian friend.
Yes. Huh? Not completely. They did until recently. The government stopped funding it properly.
Yeah. Well, they haven't funded it properly since, like, the recession of 2008.
Since the recession of 2008. Yeah, that's when...
Yeah. Yeah, you guys screwed us over, too. Yeah.
It's all Obama's fault. New York. Thanks, Obama.
Thanks, New York.
It's Obama's fault. Don't blame New York. Blame Obama.
Thanks, New York.
No, it's
thanks,
Obama.
Dirty stock traders.
Yeah, that's true. That's valid.
That's what you get for buying... insurance bonds on high risk things.
Yeah.
And buying really low interest houses. Yeah. We learn a lot about America.
Yeah. You do. How about that? We don't learn anything about you. Well, you guys just learned the boogeyman, so that's not cool.
No, we learn about the good things too. Like, you know. Like,
does anybody forget about the fact that we saved everybody from World War I and II? Okay. We literally stepped in the final hour in World War II and just
in the final,
took
you know,
them down.
Somebody had to blow up a port first before you all got
yeah,
interested.
And then we bombed the crap out of those guys.
And
right?
Then it was like, I guess we should be angry.
What's sad about that is it actually kind of sucked because at the time our president was like, we should stay on the... They were trying to basically make us isolationist at the time. I don't know if you guys learn it like that, but at the time like our president was like, we need to... steer our nation in a direction where we don't depend on other countries and we don't let other countries depend on us.
Mm.
So literally, like, our plan was to not get involved and then Japan attacked us.
Yeah, and then you were like, better drop some bombs.
Because they were all scared we were going to get involved. And it was because, like, they cut off a trade route and America was like, oh well, we'll just let it go. Yeah.
No, the U.S. cut off oil to Japan.
Yeah, you're right.
That's what it was, yeah. And then Japan was like, "Welp, what do we do? Hey, let's go fly some planes."
Well, we did that because they cut off a trade route we had as well going into France, and so we cut off one of their trade routes, and we were just gonna. It was literally like, "Give us our trade route back, and we'll give you yours back."
Yeah.
And then they didn't, and they attacked us, and so we blew them up. And in World War II was kind of similar too.
That was World War II.
I mean, World War I was kind of similar, too.
Was it? We don't learn much about World War I.
Time. We weren't in there the whole time either. History class, we kind of came into... Oh my god. You gotta do a special history class for World War One?
I think so.
Does Canada fight in any wars?
Yes. Okay. We've been involved in all of them.
Oh, you have?
Yes. Before America, even.
He says they've been involved in all of them. So you guys don't learn about World War One, but you were involved in that?
Well, no, we do learn a bit about it. Like, we don't go super in-depth basic history. But if, like, you can do, like a World War One class, I believe.
Is it pretty much if Britain gets involved in something, you guys get involved in it?
No.
Who are you?
Not.
I thought Canada was sort of closely tied to another nation.
Well, yeah, we are technically owned by the Queen.
Okay, that's what I thought. I didn't want to say that, and then that'd be like a terrible thing to say to Canadians or something.
You'd be like,
how dare you say I'm owned by the Queen?
Yeah, technically we are still part of the British Empire.
Yeah, okay.
But we're allowed to run as our own independent nation. So, like, the highest, like, the head of state, basically, is the Queen.
Do you guys learn about the American Revolution?
Yes.
You do? No way.
Yes. We learn a lot more than you learn about us.
That's so lame. You know,
we're so
nice. I might have had, like, a day in all of my schooling where I learned about Canada.
Basically.
And it might have been, like, the fact that we had to walk through your country to get to Alaska. Which is sad, because I always wanted to learn more about it.
Yeah, about we learned a bit about the U.S. and other countries.
But a lot of countries learn a lot about us, and that's because we got so involved with everybody, I guess, in the end.
Yes. Yes, indeed.
You guys learned about the Civil War?
I didn't. Not in my history class. Maybe your history class. I don't know, Matthew.
Oh, you spent the whole time learning about World War One? We didn't even spend that much. We spent like a couple weeks on World War One when I did it in history. But it's been a long time since I've done a history class.
I guess maybe it was grade 8. Maybe we spent like a whole like semester or something.
America's involvement in World War One was pretty small, so.
Well, yeah, you kind of like showed up at the last second one. We got this, guys.
Yeah, we came in and helped out. World War II was different. We came in sort of the last second for it, but we killed everybody when we came in.
Yeah, so. You came in a wee bit late.
Yeah, but we came in with nukes and everything, so.
Hey, want to hear a funny joke?
What's that?
America's involvement in Vietnam.
That is a joke, dude. That's because we did that the dumbest way possible. Like, the sad part is, like... Like, our tactic for Vietnam was the same as Korea, but we just botched it hardcore.
Yeah.
Were you guys in... I don't know. Was Canada involved in the Korean and Vietnam War?
I don't know. I think that was mostly an American thing, honest.
Yeah, I think it was, too. But I know there was some British involvement, so...
Like we've been in, like, Iraq and Syria and stuff.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
What's your military called? So, like...
The Canadian British Army?
Or not British.
Okay, well, you have the Army, you have the Navy, you have the... I think we have Marines type of things.
Right.
The Air Force.
So it's just like we have, pretty much.
Yeah, basically. Just general, normal stuff.
Do you have, like, the Eskimo Armed Forces?
No.
No? Darn it. We learned about Eskimo Armed Forces, so I'm pretty disappointed right now.
Apparently your stream froze.
Oh.
Jessica, go check the stream.
Jessica, check the stream real quick. Duber says it froze. I'll
check. According to...
I got your name right now, right? Duber?
Yes.
You always told me I didn't get it right.
Duber.
I like that more anyway.
Close enough.
Oh, God. I don't know why I like this game mode so much more. I just like the hordes. It's like zombies, and I like that, and it's amazing.
Oh, I was looking on Steam earlier, and Dawn of Discovery is like $10. for the gold edition.
Wait, Dawn of Discovery. Wait, which one is Dawn of Discovery? The new one?
No.
1503.
1404, maybe?
What?
It's 1404, but in North America it's called Dawn of Discovery.
Oh, I've never played that one before.
It's the one we were talking about before.
See, I was talking about 1602. That's the original.
Where in the world can you find a copy of 1602?
You can't. It's one that you will have to pirate, but out of necessity, because there won't be an... Yeah, we'll have to, like, you know, download it.
Yes, yes.
No. On the Uplay store, I think they actually sell it now. I think they, yeah, I think they do now. I think I read somewhere about that, but I don't know. I'll have to look into it. I would love to play that, because it's so fun.
Yeah, I'd play that. I do like the Anno games.
The Anno games are so fun. Look, if you can play this, we can do the Anno games.
Oh, exactly.
Yeah. You were telling me, like, your internet wasn't good enough for it.
Well, I didn't say it wasn't good enough. Oh. I said it, yeah. So right now it's 5 download and 1 up.
Yeah, you'll need mostly download. You don't have to. I'm not going to stream during it either, because it won't really be good for streaming.
No, it's not a very.
It's something you'll want to cut out lots of stuff.
Exactly. Probably. Like this right here is going to be like a week's worth of, not a week's, but like three.
Yeah, you need to get on your uploading. 3 weeks. Start uploading crap.
Worth of, like, I'm just going to chop this up.
Yeah. That's what I would do. But what I'm going to do with mine is I'm going to just upload the whole thing. And then I'm going to make something where I condense it down to, like, 5 minutes and upload the
5 minutes?
Yeah.
Yeah, all the best we've stuff. Been playing for about 2 hours and 15 minutes.
Okay, 10 minutes. Happy?
So if you do... Okay, hang on. I'm going to kill myself so I can do some math.
Oh my god.
Pulling out the calculator. Okay, so let's say about.
Oh god.
Times 60. That's 120 plus 30. Okay, so that's 150 minutes. And if you do it in. I don't know. What's a good number? Like 15, 20 minutes?
What do you mean? Wait. Huh?
Well. If you chopped it up like 15 to 20 minutes per episode.
Well, you could just chop it up. I would just chop it up again according to like what game we were playing and stuff like that. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Like every time we switch to a different game, that's an episode pretty much. Maybe. But like for me, I'm going to take... I don't mean like I'm going to chop it into 5-minute episodes. I mean, I'm going to upload the whole thing. And then there's going to be one where I'm just going to... pick out the best parts and make like a shortened version, like a funny minutes kind of thing, like my H1Z1 video if you saw it.
Yes.
Did you?
Okay. Yes.
Like that kind of. That was like hours of H1Z1. So.
Yeah. Oh jeez, what have I done?
H1Z1 takes forever too. So.
And that's such a well optimized game.
Oh yeah, it's high quality.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, totes my goats.
No glitches the whole time.
No. Ever. Zilch.
How come this guy's still alive? Okay, he's it.
Oh. He's a magic man.
So I've learned so much about Canada today. I'm so
exactly.
proud.
Exactly.
Okay,
you know?
I had a question. Was slavery a big deal in Canada? Because it was basically the deal in America.
Yes, and not really. I don't think so. I don't want to say no and then have somebody yell at me. I don't think so.
Like exploit. We need your fact checking here.
I'm like Canada had like a really bad thing. So we took like all the First Nations people and we put them in reserves. Like really bad, low quality.
Like your Indians, right?
Yeah.
When you say First Nation, I think people who live in the first world for some reason. First Nation.
And then we did something bad. We took their kids and we put them in residential schools. And basically it was these white racist teachers and they would beat the kids and assault the kids and like they would sexually assault them too.
Oh, that's not cool.
So we've done some bad things.
So your things were mainly, well, we did stuff to our Native Americans too.
Oh yeah.
Pretty rough. Like we would like to tell them you can have this area and then we'd come back 10 years later and be like, actually, we want it now.
Actually, I'm gonna need to take that.
Yeah, pretty much. That's all pretty messed up. I didn't know if slavery was a big deal then.
I don't know if it was.
I don't know when Canada happened. Mass genocide of the Indians was a thing in Canada. But that, okay.
Yeah.
We did pretty decent genocide of Indians.
Genocide of the Indians. Yeah. Yeah. We're nowhere near as bad as, you know, like, Germany.
Yeah, well, yeah. Because they just killed everybody. But we killed a good amount of our Native Americans, too, so... I don't know, it's just something you do. To me, I mean,
something you do.
You're trying to take over the place, you're gonna have to kill somebody. I mean, it sucks that it had to happen, but it's just the way it, just sort of the way it goes. I mean, cat, get off the table right now, darn it. I know there's a pen up here, but it's not the time.
My pen. There's always time for pens.
That's what he says.
What were you thinking? There's always time for pens.
Okay, that's a chest plate. Cat, die, please.
Wow.
That was mean, wasn't it?
So violent to your cat. Your cat just wants to hate you, too.
Oh, he literally took off with my pen.
Wow. Quality catting.
Good thing I'm not playing Minecraft. Oh my god! Oh my god! Run!
Too busy playing with the cat.
Yeah, that's
realize what's happening. Oh, you're gonna
die. That guy wasn't even looking at me and he threw a sling thing at me. How come I don't ever grab the health? What the heck? I have serious problems with grabbing health. Is there like a secret?
I don't think so. Right,
here we go. Health. Maybe if I slow down? There you go. I just have to stop and do it.
Yeah, so basically, in a nutshell, Canada is okay.
Okay, so when I think Canada, I think poutine as food. What do you think when you think America for food? Is there an American food you think of?
Well, see, we have, like, almost all of the American, like, food chains here now.
Right.
So...
Everyone does, pretty much.
Like, I don't know. Lard. Lard is a good one.
Lard?
I don't know, not really. Maybe, anything from Disney World. I don't know. Jeez.
Anything from Disney World?
Oh, you know what I did have that was really good one time? This probably sounds like so, like... weird coming from somebody who actually lives in the U.S. I was at the Chicago airport, and they had it was like some hot dog place, like a big chain.
Sure. Yeah.
And it was good.
Okay, so you would think hot dogs maybe.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fair. So you think hot dogs is poutine a fair assessment of Canadian lifestyle?
No.
You don't think so?
I don't think so. Maybe it might be.
I mean, as a food that sums up Canada, like Canada's food, you don't think poutine's it? Because that's the only Canadian food I even know of.
Oh, we have this really horrible... It's not even Canadian. It's actually like Norwegian and German. It's called Lutefisk. Or lutefisk.
Lutefisk? Is that fish?
Yeah, you might know it by lutefisk.
I've heard of it, kind of, I think.
Yeah, so lutefisk is like, it's fish that's been soaked in lye and then left to sit.
Ew.
And it's basically like rotten fish.
Ew, that's disgusting.
And you eat them, and you leave the skin on.
Sounds delicious.
It's the most disgusting thing you will ever eat.
Oh my gosh, I've such a hard time. You've never had it?
No, my grandma's, like, one uncle or something used to eat it, used to make them, or no, her dad. They used to always have to have that at, like, Thanksgiving, with lutefisk.
Uh-huh.
So gross.
Oh my god. Why is this so hard all of a sudden? What the freaking heck? And people were saying things in chat like, thanks, archers. I'm trying my hardest here, darn it. We're having a conversation, darn it. It's hard to fight.
Talking about the shortcomings of Canada.
Yeah. So, I need to try poutine soon. I guess I'll try it at that restaurant and see what I think about it. We'll see if it's good, but I'm sure they put Velveeta on it.
No. It has to be a white cheese. Costco has great poutine.
Well, there is white Velveeta.
Is there?
Yeah, but it tastes the exact same.
That's wrong.
I'm pretty sure they just dye it white. Or don't dye it yellow.
Do your Costcos have the cafeteria?
I've never been to Costco.
You've never been to Costco?
We have Costco. I've just never been to it. Who are you? It's not as big of a thing here, I don't think. I think it's a big thing, but it's more of a West Coast thing. But we have one in our area. I've just never been there. Oh, I'm more of a Sam's Costco's Club kind of guy.
Oh, tisk tisk. Costco is great.
Yeah, my girlfriend says it's great.
Okay, so basically, she's been to Costco, right?
Yes. She has. I actually have a membership her mom bought me, but I've just never been.
Ask her if they have the cafeterias.
Jessica, does Costco have the cafeterias?
Like the cafeteria thing? Yes. Yes? Do they sell poutine?
Do they sell poutine?
No.
She says they don't, but they have the best pizza.
Yes, we do have... Okay, we have the pizza. We have, the chicken finger and fries. And then we have, the $1.50 hot dog with a drink.
Nice.
Yes. Great. And then we have poutine. And Costco fries. Plus... It's so delicious. They have this weird crispness on them. They're weird. You can even buy them at the store in a ridiculously oversized bag.
The hot dogs?
No. You can buy the hot dogs too.
Wait, what were we just talking about being crisp?
The fries.
Oh, the fries, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Are the fries there good, hon? Jessica.
Yes.
Oh, you're thinking?
I haven't had the fries.
She hasn't had the fries. Fries. She says she doesn't know.
Maybe they don't have them. Missing out.
She doesn't think they have them here.
You don't have fries at Costco in Canada? Not in Canada, in the United States.
I mean, we have fries elsewhere, but not in Costco, I guess. I bet they do. They might, but... Chicken bakes. You can hear, right?
A little bit.
Caesar salad.
Yeah, we have Caesar salad.
Yogurt?
Like frozen yogurt.
Frozen yogurt.
We don't have frozen yogurt.
Three different kinds of pizza. You have the hot dog and soda deals. I think there's also an Italian beef.
An Italian beef.
I think that's really it.
So it was Exploit saying he drinks beer all the time.
No.
That's what it seemed like.
He does not.
He was talking about if he drinks... I couldn't keep up with the chat in the game because I was trying to not die. I feel bad about it now. I'm going to get the bombs this time. Just real quick. Oh no, it gets rid of my bow! Oh, I hate my life. God dang it. And I only get one? This costs so much money. Dude, I literally got one of those. And I threw it at the most basic troop. Oh no, no, steam menu. Bad timing. Oh, now I have no points either. No, steam menu again. Oh my gosh. Oh, freaking steam. Okay, we're dead. Oh, my headphones hurt my ears so freaking bad. Now that I have my mic not part of my headphone, I need to get new headphones so badly.
What kind of mic do you have?
ATR 2100. It's pretty nice.
Ooh.
Now, everybody gets Blue Yetis, but I hear this one's better, and so far I like it quite a bit.
How's my sound quality?
Yours is good.
It's good?
Yeah.
Okay.
What are you using?
The Blue Yeti.
Pro or Snowball?
No, it's the big tall one.
Big tall one.
It's the blackout one.
Yeah, I was gonna get that. Everybody said that the ATR 2100 was actually higher quality, but I'm not even using it properly right now. I have it like off at the side where you're nice, and I think it sounds pretty good still.
I have like the whole boom stand thing going on.
It sounds a lot better than my old mic, that's for sure.
Yes.
My old mic was crap.
Toaster mic.
Yes, it was attached to my Turtle Beach.
Toaster mic Caleb.
Yes. Wait, where's that free sword at? I need that.
There.
Found it. Are you dead?
Yes.
Why do you keep dying, darn it? I did not grab the sword.
I don't know what happened. I got ganged up on.
That's maybe? Usually what I say.
That's the story I'm gonna go with. I got ganged up on. Dead.
Nope, run.
Yeah.
I should go heal, probably. I just want to buy a bow. Freaking everything sells your bow, and I hate that, because all I want is a bow.
You know what's crazy? Like, I bet you, like, 80% of what's on TV is American in Canada.
Really? Well, yeah, yes. That makes sense. We make lots of TV.
Yeah. Like, that's like 90% of our TV, probably, would be American produced stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you watch from America? Tell me an American show you watch. You watch TV.
We have Mythbusters.
Mythbusters, that's ending.
Okay. Yes. We have Modern Family.
I don't know
what that is. We have The Big Bang Theory.
He said Mythbusters.
We have
Big Bang Theory.
Blue Bloods. I think Blue Bloods is American, isn't it?
Blue it Bloods? No, I've never heard of that before. You have The Walking Dead.
Yes.
Do you watch that?
No.
Oh, I'm so
I
dead.
Stopped watching after like season 2.
Oh, it got better though.
No, it didn't. I've catched snippets and it hasn't gotten better for me.
You're just like, no, it hasn't.
The story has just gotten too much of the same. No, I watched up until Lori died, and then I was like, no.
Oh my gosh, like, it got better after Lori died.
I was
Lori
like,
ruined the show.
No, I can't deal with the governor guy and his one eye.
Yeah, I hear that.
So I just went, no, I'm done. TTYL.
Okay, I just need horde troopers to kill right now.
You have 35 people to kill. 34.
I need points. I need my bow back. I can't do anything. About a Jew. What about a Jew?
What? Watch About a Jew in Canada? I don't know what he's talking about.
Is there a show about a Jew?
No. There might be. I don't know. Oh, you know what we have, though? We have our own, like, version of Netflix. Like, we have Netflix, but then we have, like, these two new things called, like, Crave TV and Show Me.
Oh, I think we have Crave TV, too. I think we can get that. I think I've heard of it, but I'm not sure.
Yeah. It's new.
Jeez.
Like, before to get it, you had to be, like, your TV provider had to, you know, be a part of it.
Are all these people trying to tell me what to do? Okay, if you want to tell me what to do, how about be alive?
Ooh.
Do you see all them telling me what to do in chat? What the heck, guys? I'm not even paying attention. I'm just running around talking to you.
The duck bomb was great.
I literally got rid of my bow for the freaking bomb, and now I'm regretting that.
Oh, look at that guy in the spikes. He's, like, glitching out.
Okay, I can't kill any of those guys, so...
Look at him. What's he doing?
I need points. Keep them away from the valley. Dang. I shouldn't have done that.
Well, you know, I think I'm gonna go to bed.
Alright, sounds good. I thought I should too.
Yes.
Alright, it's been
I'm
fun.
I'm at the point where my throat is killing me.
Talking about poutine too much.
Probably, you know, should have had like some water or something.
Yeah, me too, actually.
Some pre-planning.
Yeah.
Would have been good.
It wouldn't have hurt anything.
Wouldn't have hurt.